Hi guys, got a plastic milk bottle here and I have an idea. I was looking at it, in fact I was about to throw it out for the recycling. I was looking at it and I thought this top section with this sticky out bit, the handle, looks to me a bit like a weevil, a beetle, but there's stag beetles that have nice, interesting pointy bits, horns at the front. And I'm sure I'd seen a picture of one that had a pointy bit like this that then went out hammer-shaped. But I've looked for pictures like that and I can't find one that's exactly what I want. But I can see weevils. And weevils have long... They're not really noses. In fact, I think it's their head because they've got... sort of feelers stick out right down at this end. Anyway, a lot of waffle. I'm going to try and make this, cut it out and make it look like a weevil. So we want this bit. We don't want very much around here. We probably only want it around about this sort of height for the actual body, and yeah, we want to chop this off down here somewhere, but we want to have legs, and I looked at it and the legs appear to come near the front. In fact, I think it has a segment there with a couple of legs out the front here somewhere. And then it has two more legs out of this bit. Now, in an ideal world, you'd sort of make them more sort of for the joins in the legs, but I'll try and keep it simple. So that's a long leg down there. One sticking out the front. In fact, I'll make that one a bit bigger. This is whiteboard marker. It should rub off again. It probably will rub off on my fingers when I'm trying to do the cutting out. Obviously, once you cut it out, you're going to fold them out because their legs go out like that. Right, now we're going to use a sharp knife and scissors. So, probably not one for the youngsters, this. So, not made for children because we're using a sharp knife. Or at the very least, adult supervision. We'll worry about that in a minute. I'm in fact thinking about it, we've got to come down there anyway. That would go all the way around. And come down here too. Stiffer around the front here. Thank you. see if we can finish this off with scissors. I should think if we go along that line there, those legs will be long. Probably look better like that too. A little bit more insect-like. I don't know what shape feet they have. Some of them have got little claw things. I'm probably worrying too much about detail, aren't I? Bit light and it's just sort of rolling away from me while I'm trying to cut it. Thank you. the general shape of it. Right, so I'll chuck all that lot away and we'll look at some sort of paint effect for this one. I need to trim that front a little bit. The weevil is just going to a round, short round bit. I just like the idea of having that. Looks like a vacuum cleaner. So this isn't exactly a weevil. Right, I'll tie you up and then we'll do some painting. Well, I'm looking through the acrylic paints I've got, and one of the pictures I was looking at, it was sort of black with white speckles sort of thing. But I noticed I got some acrylic metallic paints here. I just thought that might make an interesting colour. So I'll use some of that. Certainly for the body. Might not be thick enough. Probably should have given it a coat of white or something first, shouldn't I? Just as a base. Still, we can build it up with several coats, can't we? Yeah, I would definitely recommend giving it a base coat first. Although, that's not bad. Not bad, but not what I want. So this is going to be several coats. Once we use this up, when I've squeezed it out. Might do a bit of black on the legs and that. Any black that's been opened? Right, we'll come back later. I'll probably do a few more coats and then we'll have a look what it looks like. Certainly do a bit more detail on the body there. Well, the hot sunshine has helped dry the paint. In fact, it's had a second coat of that gold. And I've added a couple of little feeler things at the front there, so it's a bit closer to the weevil shape. Although the weevil doesn't have my vacuum cleaner nose like that. So, yeah, I think that worked out quite nicely. I mean, could add a few more colours to it. I think I'm rather pleased with that. Make myself a cup of coffee as well. So there we go. A weevil beetle from a plastic milk bottle. Job done. Well, that was annoying. I just started editing the video and realised I hadn't put eyes on it. So I've just added some eyes for a final photo. The actual weevils, the eyes are quite large, buggy, bug eyes. So I've just squirted a bit of that 3D, what do we call it? Not that stuff. That stuff. 3D pearl effect. So yeah, my weevil now has eyes.
Thanks for watching. You'll find more information down in the video description. You might like to watch that video up there. And you might like to subscribe over there.